Hi guys, welcome to this Speed Build video in The Sims 4. My name is Irene and today I am building my steampunk birdcage. Yes, this is going to be a massive birdcage with a steampunk house in it. And yeah, I was talking about a very strange build coming up during my last video that froze a waterfall. Well, this is it. But I cannot wait to share it with you guys because I had so much fun with it. I really wanted to do a steampunk styled build again. It was a long time ago that I did one, and the new build and buy items with a new game pack, Star Wars Journey to Batuu for The Sims 4. A lot of very cool steampunk slash industrial styled items. So yeah, I was just tempted to do a steampunk build again. The Amazing Fry from Simproof did a steampunk style build as well last week, and I think her main inspiration were these new items as well. There are a lot of cool, like I said, a mixture between industrial and steampunk items with that pack. And normally I always love building these extremely sleek and futuristic builds, so I wanted to challenge myself again as well with a completely different style. I started thinking what I could do with the steampunk builds, and I didn't want to make just a house or a library, not just a normal build. I wanted to do something a little bit special, a little bit different. So I started gathering inspiration on Google and on Pinterest. And at a certain point I came across a picture of a massive clock with a house in it. And that sparked my imagination to do a house in something. I came across pictures of massive stilettos with houses in them and cuckoo's clocks with houses in them. And yeah, that whole thing intrigued me. So I started to think what I could do with that. And I also came across a lot of pictures of bird cages that were in the steampunk style. Mainly with bonsai trees in them, but that whole thing sparked my imagination to do a steampunk house inside a birdcage. I also started thinking about that massive birdcage in Dark Souls. I don't know if you know Dark Souls, it's a franchise Japanese RPG from Software, and it's one of my favorite games ever, franchises ever. Extremely difficult games, but yeah, when you get the hang of it, it's amazing with a lot of interesting lore, and yeah, I love it. And if I'm correct, in Dark Souls 3, I'm not totally sure though, but in Dark Souls 3, there was an area called the Grand Archives, and if I'm correct, there was a massive birdcage there, and you could drop down in it. And there was a very special item at the bottom, something like a spell. But when I had that in my mind, I really got, whole inspired to do this build because I love the game so much and that whole steampunk style. So that's how my whole, imagination process went. But let's go to this build. As you can see, the most part of the birdcage is already finished. That item that you can see on the ground, it kind of clips in the ground. It's from the Star Wars pack, and the item that you can see hanging underneath the entire birdcage is from the Star Wars pack as well. Two examples of great industrial steampunk styled items. That massive item in the ground, I made it there. The bottom layer of the birdcage is actually just the bottom layer of a house, the first level. Normally you always have that foundation underneath it, but there is a foundation type after you used the bb.showhiddenobjects cheat that is invisible. And I used that to make that foundation disappear. But then you have a huge gap in the ground where normally the foundation used to be. So I made a basement over there, and I removed the roof of the basement, and over there I placed that massive round item. And yeah, after that I had enough height, still enough levels left to make this build that high. You cannot build higher than 4 levels in the game. So normally I always just use the second, third and fourth level and I delete the first level to make builds float. But because I wanted to make this build very tall, of course, I used that method with that invisible foundation. I use a lot of these pillars all around this build to give it that birdcage look. And normally you cannot place pillars in this way. Normally when you want to place in pillars, they always click on the grid. You cannot place them freely. I got a couple of questions, not really requests, questions about how to place objects freely in the game. So I wanted to explain you a bit about that as well. It's actually very, very easy. You have to use the bb.moveObjects cheat, of course. Then, after you selected item, hold Alt on your keyboard and hold your left mouse button. And that way you can rotate objects freely. But it doesn't work with pillars. So I had to come up with a different solution because otherwise I couldn't place these pillars in a circle like this. And these are actually debug pillars. You can just find them amongst the base game items in your debug menu. It's not really a debug menu, but amongst the debug items, you know what I mean. And this pillar, it comes in a couple of different colors. It comes in black, in green, in gray, and in white. Over here, they're gray, but later on I will change them up in black. But you can place them freely, of course. And that's how I could place them in this circle. We're already on the house, but I still wanted to explain a little bit about these circles that you can see all around the birdcage. I used the same method for it again as well that I used a couple of times before in previous builds. I placed a deck on that level, then I placed an extremely sized up rock on that deck to use it as a template. Then I used items on the upper circle. I used a small stone fence, debug fence that came with Jungle Adventure. The middle circle is a kitchen cabinet, a kitchen counter. And the bottom circle, I used three different items there. A classical fence, another fence, and later on I will use the black porcelain pedestal over there as well. But you can use different items, like I said, just place them all next to each other on that line of the rock you just placed in, and after that you can remove the rock, you can remove the deck, and then you have that circle. But yes, we're already way into the house inside the birdcage, and I actually thought long and hard about what to do with the house in the birdcage. I already said it before, but normally I love building very modern, futuristic and sleek builds. And because I already did a lot of them, I always already kind of know what to do, but this was a completely new style for me. So I had to think a lot about what to do with the house in it. Of course, I didn't want to make a modern house in it. It would be kind of strange. I wanted to make it steampunk styled. So I searched on Pinterest and on Google as well. And I saw a lot of Victorian steampunk styled houses. I didn't want to make it too big, of course, because it had to fit in that birdcage. So I just started with it. I placed different rooms, boxes. I combined them all together. I placed them on different spots with different heights, different sizes, of course, different shapes. And that's how the whole house kind of took his shape. And then I just placed roofs everywhere. And in that way, the whole house in the birdcage kind of the whole process was kind of organically. I just experimented with this for different shapes and different rooms here and there. And that way I made this house. And of course with all these pointy roofs everywhere. After that, when I was finished with the shape of the house, I just took a step back, took a look at it, and I went through all the new items from that Star Wars pack. I went through the debug items and just placed some items on it that started me thinking about steampunk. The Get to Work Pack, actually, the first expansion pack that we got for The Sims 4, came with some very cool steampunk items as well. So I used a couple of them on this build too. And now, yeah, the whole process about deciding what colors I wanted to give this house. I wanted to make it, yeah, pop. Not just all the same gray color. And you can see in a couple of minutes, yeah, over here, I'm just placing in the colors right now. My initial plan, my initial color scheme was just gray. Gray for the entire birdcage, gray for the house. It kind of, yeah, reminded me of an industrial style. But when I took a look at the whole thing, I thought it's just gray. It's only gray and I want to use more color. So this item that I'm just placing in, timing, that's a roof accent that came with the Island Living pack. And it had that pop of blue color in it. And I thought, yeah, I just have to do more with color. I want to make it pop out of the birdcage where you take a look at this build. Not just a gray color scheme. So I decided to add yellow and to add a red in this build as well. Of course, I did that with a couple of yellow trees. They came with Island Living and some yellow roof colors everywhere. And later on, especially inside the house, you can find the color scheme as well. The red and the yellow, and inside the house will be a lot of black too. And when I did all these colors on the house, with the yellow and with the other colors that you can see a little bit later on with plants that I placed in, I thought that whole gray birdcage was a little bit too bland as well, a little bit too gray. So that's why I changed the color of all the pillars into black and all the items that I used on the exterior. And I thought it just popped a little bit more. But when you're pulling this from the gallery, because of course I will upload it there so you can use it in your own game if you want. You can easily change up the color back into gray if you like that a little bit more. But I think it just, yeah, pops a little bit more of your screen with more bright colors. Over here, plants, flowers. Like I said, I wanted to give this build a little bit more, not just a bland gray. The massive, machine part that you can see right there. And yes, yet again, I pointed at my screen like I always do when I'm recording voiceovers. It's a very cool industrial / steampunk item that came with the Star Wars pack as well. And I will use it a couple of times in the interior as well, in the interior too. And yeah, I also wanted to give it a little bit more red here and there because I thought it matched good with the yellow. So that's why I placed some red ivy on the exterior too. Now we're on to the interior. And yeah, this first level over here, I wanted to make this birdcage very tall, so I needed a very tall level height. So these walls look huge. It's because it's the tallest level height. Oh, and with this interior, I had so much fun. I don't know if it's really, really steampunk, but it was what my imagination was thinking while I was thinking about steampunk. Very strange sentence. But I wanted to go for these pops of color, the red and the yellow, because I had these color on the exterior as well. Wanted to use a lot of mirrors, a lot of clocks everywhere, and I wanted to combine that with these very cool new items with the Star Wars pack. There are especially some amazing new lights with that Star Wars pack, hanging lights, and of course I had to use them in this build as well, because now I could use them in this team. Another pack that I used a lot in this build, especially in the interior, was actually the Vampires pack. A lot of cool steampunk items with the Vampires pack as well. They're mainly Victorian styled items, but for me steampunk and Victorian kind of blends together. For me, steampunk is how people in the late 1880s saw the future, but in their own Victorian style. I don't know if I said something completely wrong right now, but that's how I think about steampunk when I think about steampunk style builds. This kitchen is functional. It's very, very small because, yeah, of course, I didn't have that much space in this house, but it is functional. And I was so happy with the ladders in the game that we have them right now because I use them a lot in this build as well. Only ladders, no normal stairs. A couple of different reasons why I didn't use normal stairs. Main reason, space. There wasn't that much space in this house already. And with ladders you can make houses functional and they take in way less space, of course. But I'm building this house in an angle as well, in a diagonal. It's always a difficult word for me. But yeah, I'm building it in an angle and you cannot place stairs in angles. So yeah, I was extremely happy that we got ladders now in the game. I think this is one of my favorite rooms in the entire house. That a bedroom, but we're already on the bathroom. I will place a library in this build as well. And a very small office too. But I think, yeah, then we're already at the end of this video. Yeah, just a bedroom and the bathroom and the library. There are a couple of tower rooms, small rooms above this bathroom. Yeah, I don't know anybody with a ladder in their bathroom, but in this house you have a ladder in your bathroom and you have a bathtub. You can see it in a couple of seconds, just one level higher. And in the library it's kind of the same thing, but you have a desk over there one level higher. Yeah, over here I wanted to make a special room for a bathtub. But yeah, then we're in the end. Yet again, very, very curious what you thought about this strange build. Very curious. If you have some requests for me to build, please let me know. I love reading your requests. From a couple of requests, I already made screenshots, so maybe I can use them in the future. But if you have a request for me, please let me know. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't done that already. I love to do a lot of different things with my builds. I love to challenge myself with my builds. So yeah, if you want to keep yourself inspired for builds in The Sims, or if you just like to watch speed build videos, I think you're in the right place, so please subscribe. I cannot wait to talk to you guys next Friday during my next video. I hope you will all have an amazing day. And yeah, talk to you then. Goodbye.